Okay guys, so the CPM part is like this. Why I get us, so the maximum time to complete the process is 22. If you are going to check it out, 1 to 2, 2 to 4, 4 to 6, and 6 to 7. No, I am going to teach you the power calculation. The forward calculation is as follows. So fix E1 equal to 0. Fix E1 equal to 0. So fix E1 equal to 0. Now we move on. E2. E2 is coming from E1 plus time taken from 1 to 2. That is, E2 is coming from E1, that is E1, plus time taken from 1 to 2. So the value is E1 is 0 plus time taken from 1 to 2 is 6. The value is 6. Now, E3 is coming from E1 plus time taken from 1, 2, 3. So, E3 is coming from E1 plus time taken from 1, 2, 3. E1 is 0 plus time taken from 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3 is 4. The answer is again 4. Now, E4. E4 is coming from 3 and as well as 2. So, take the maximum of E2 plus time taken from 2, 4. E3 plus time taken from 3, 4, which is equal to maximum of E2 is 6 plus time taken from 2, 4 is 5. E3 is 4 plus time taken from 3, 4 is 6. Obviously, 11. Now, E5 is coming from only 2, that is E2 plus time taken from 2, 5. This is E2 is 6 plus time taken from 2, 5 is 3, this is 9, and E6 is coming from E4, and again if I take the maximum of E4 plus time taken from 4, 6, and E5 plus time taken from 5, 6, which is equal to maximum of E4 is 11 plus time taken from 4, 6 is 8. And E5 is 9 plus time taken from 5, 6 is 4. This is all about 19. And the last one for you, E7 is coming from E6 plus time taken from 6, 7. E6 is 19 plus time taken from 6, 7 is 3. Obviously, 20. This is all about the forward calculation. So, I'm going to represent all the values here. This is all about E2. The value of E2 is 6. The value of E3. E3 is 4. E4 is 11. E5 is 9. E6 is 19. And E17 is 22. These are the forward calculations. Okay, now we will move on to the backward calculations. That the reverse part, that is a backward calculation. Backward calculations. So the backward calculation for you is L7. I am fixing L7 as 22. What we got is 22 for the forward. You have to make sure that for the backward calculation also the value should be repeated. So 22 L7. Now we will move on to L6. L6 is inching towards L7, that is L7 minus time taken from 6, 7. So L7 is 22 minus time taken from 6, 7 is 3. This is all about 19. Now L5. L5 is inching towards L6 minus time taken from 6, 5. This is L6 is 19 minus 6, 5 is 4. This is all about 15. Now L4. L4 is inching towards L6 minus time taken from 6, 4. Then this is all about 19 minus 6, 4 is 8. This is all about 11. Now L3. L3 is inching towards L4 minus time taken from 4, 3. L4 is 11 minus 4, 3 20 is 6, the answer is 5. And L2, you just see here, L2 is inching towards 4 and inching towards 5. So take the minimum of, why? Because it's a backward arrow. So backward means you have to consider minimum of L4 minus time taken from 4 comma 2 and one more L5 minus time taken from 5 comma 2, which is equal to minimum of, what is L4? L4 is 11 minus time taken from 4 comma 2 is 5. And again, for L5, L5 is 15 minus time taken from 5 comma 2 is 3. The minimum is 6. And the last one for you, L1. So L1 is inching towards 1 and inching towards 3. Again, you have to consider minimum of L3 minus time taken from 3 comma 1 and L2 minus time taken from 2 comma 1. So which is equal to minimum of, what is L3? 5 minus 3 comma 1, 3 comma 1 is 4. L2 is 6 minus time taken from 2 comma 1, again 6. Obviously the balance should be minimum 0. This is 0 and this is 1, and 1 and 0, the minimum is 0. So simply we are going to substitute here. So all of you, the forward is 0, at the same time the backward also 0. Here we go. So L2, what is L2? We got 6. And again, L3 is 5, L4 is 11, and this is E5, and again this is L5, L5 is 15, and L6 is 19, and L22 is 22. So these are your backward calculations. So the first part is over. So after that, I wanna teach you the cost slope. And again, the crash cost activity and the indirect cost per day is 100. This information is given. From this information, we have to calculate all this. We are going to crash this network diagram up to 21 days. Okay, guys, now we are going to find out the cost slope here. The cost slope, the formula is crash cost minus normal cost by normal time minus crash time. This is CC minus NC by NC minus C. So you have to ask only the critical path values. 1 to 2, the CPM path 1 to 2, 2 to 4, 4 to 6, and 6 to 7. So if you observe the question, you have to consider only these activities, only 1 to 2 you have to consider, 2 to 4 you have to consider, and again 4 to 6, and 6 to 7. So for this, we are going to apply the formula. Here we go. The crash cost for this, the crash cost is 1000. 1000 minus normal cost is 600 by normal time 6 minus 4. So this is all about 400 by 2. So, and the next one is called 2 to 4. For 2 to 4, this is 1500 minus 500. 1500 minus 500 by 5 minus 3. So 1500 minus 500 is 1000. 1000 by 2, which is equal to 500. Okay, guys, for 4 to 6, and again 6 to 7, we are going to calculate. So for 4 to 6, so that is 3000 minus 8800. By 8 minus 4. So obviously the value is 2200 divided by 4, the answer is 550. And the last one for you, that is 6 to 7, that is 800 minus 450 by 3 minus 2. So obviously the difference is 350 by 1, obviously 350. So this is about the cost slope. We calculated cost slope here. Okay, so all you have to do is you have to crash the activity up to 21 days all of it. If you observe the cost slope, the least cost is 200. We observe here, the least cost is 200. So the 200 is the activity 1 to 2. So I'm gonna crash this activity 1 to 2 for 1 day. So we have to make this 22 as 21 days of it. Okay, now I'm going to apply the crash cost method for this. Now we are going to crash the activity 1, 2, 2, why? Because the cost of each token is the least. So I'm going to crash this activity 1, 2, 2 with 1 day less. So that is, this is the activity 1, 2, 2. I'm crashing this activity 1, 2, 2 with the 1 day, that is 5 days. As usual, 3. This is 4. And again, this is again 4. Again, apply. This is 6. 5. Again, this is 5. And this is 6. Again, this. And this is 7. And the CV path will be same, that is 1 to 2, obviously 5. Plus 5 is 10. 10 plus 8 is 18. 18 plus 3 is 21. If you observe the question, you have to crash the activity up to 21 days. Okay, again, I will teach you the form back of calculation that fix even equal to 0. I'm repeating the same procedure of E2. E is coming from even, that is 0 plus 5 again 5. For 3, this 0 plus 4 again 4. Then here we go. 4. This is all about 4 plus 6 is 10. For E5 is coming from, again 5 plus 5 10, again 6 plus 4, no problem. For 5 is also coming from 2, that is for E2 is 5, and again 2 to 5 is 3, 5 plus 3 is 8. For E6, we have a clash from 4 to 6 and again 5 to 6. So 10 plus 8 is 18, and again 5 to 6 is 4, that is 8 plus 4, 12. So 18 and 12, the maximum is obviously 18, and again, this is 18 plus 3 is 20. These are the forward calculations straight away. Now we move on to the backward calculation. Fix 21 here. Okay, like this. So 21 minus 3 is 18. And again, that is again 5. So 5, I will move on to 6. So that is 18 minus 4 is again 14. And again for 4, 4 is inching towards 6. So that is E6 is 18 minus 8 is 10. And again for 3, 3 is inching towards 4, that is 10 minus 6 is again 4. And again for 2, inching towards 4 and inching towards 5, that is 10 minus 5 is 5. And again 14 minus 3 again 11, the minimum is again 5. And again obviously 4 minus 4 again 0, 5 minus again 0, these are the zeros. So we have to crash this activity up to 21 days, so we got our 21 days. Clear? So obviously if you observe here, the direct cost is, the direct cost, we are going to add these to 600, 1200, if you are going to add these values, the answer is again 4700 rupees. The indirect cost is given for 100 rupees. So the indirect cost is 100 rupees times of the previous one, that is 22, that is 2200. So the total cost is 4700 plus 2200, that is 6900. This is all about the crash cost method. If for example, if it is up to 90, for example, again you have to find the cost flow for this, take the minimum of the cost flow, again you have to crash that data up to the 19 days. If it is 16, up to 16, like that. Thanks a lot for watching this video. Thank you.